At one all after the first leg, this tie always bound to be a nip and tuck affair, so it proved as Fulham moved ahead on 15 minutes, Robert Hayworth applying the header to Gary Brazil's cross. David Pleat hasn't won a Coca-Cola Cup tie since returning to Luton, when Kerry Hughes was shown the red card for retaliation after being fouled by Michael Myson, things looked very bleak. From the free kick though, the 10-man Hatters were immediately back in the hunt thanks to Dwight Marshall's first goal for the club. 2-2 on aggregate then at the end of 90 minutes, no goals in extra time, so all down to the dreaded shootout. First up, Alan Cork for Fulham, Jürgen Sommer with the save. But man of the match, Jim Stannard not to be outdone, a save from Luton's Paul Telfer. Julian Hales next to give Fulham the edge before Stannard did the business again, foiling Scott Oakes. Then Gary Brazil making amends for an extra time penalty miss, 2-0. A cool head from the experienced David Priest pulled it back to 2-1, then 3-1 to Fulham, Duncan Jupp the scorer. Kerry Dixon kept Luton in the tie, a belter, 3-2, and luck seemed to be on Luton's side as Kevin Moore struck the woodwork, leaving Johnson to rattle home the 10th penalty, 3-all and down to sudden death. Glenn Thomas on target for Fulham, putting the pressure on Dwight Marshall. It was too much. Another save from Stannard and victory to Fulham, 4-3 on penalties.